ओम शांति। 25 मई 2020, टुडेज बाबदादा साकार मुरली इज एक्चुअली डेडिकेटेड टू द पाथ ऑफ डिवोशन, वेयर बाबा विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट फ्यू मिथ्स रिगार्डिंग गॉड एंड हिज एग्जिस्टेंस एंड ऑल द फॉल्स बिलीफ सिस्टम्स दैट हैड बीन प्रैक्टिस्ड फॉर लाइक लास्ट 2500 ईयर्स। बट बिफोर दैट, बिफोर डिस्कसिंग ऑल दैट, वील बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ब्लेसिंग वेयर बाबा सेड, मे यू क्लेम अ राइट टू एन एलिवेटेड स्टेटस बाय ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग योर सेल्फ एंड बिकमिंग एन इमेज ऑफ सपोर्ट फॉर द वर्ल्ड। राइट टू एन एलिवेटेड स्टेटस बाय ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग योर सेल्फ, दिस हैज टू बी अंडरलाइन, वेयर बाबा हैज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन ब्लेसिंग दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग योर सेल्फ, यू चिल्ड्रन थिंक दैट वी शुड रैदर चेंज द सिचुएशन और द इंडिविजुअल रिस्पॉन्सिबल इन दैट पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन। Instead of keeping an eye to transform yourself, we keep such false aims. Shri Baba said that if you seek some sort of cooperation, support or salvation from others, so all that your account of accumulation will be shared between that individual or that many whom you are seeking help to. Therefore, always have the aim of transforming yourself. Basically, Baba is trying to make us independent, that is dependent on ourselves. That you should transform yourself by having and keeping faith on yourself, Baba, and of course Dharma. Only these pillars, these three pillars are worth and sufficient enough to transform any individual. And Shiv Baba also said that zeal and enthusiasm and of course elevated thoughts of a gathering is very, very important if you want to guarantee the success. Like we said that today's Murli is actually dedicated to the path of devotion. So where Shiv Baba has discussed that. They say that Krishna is God. So they should be asked, Krishna wouldn't be called the father. Krishna wouldn't be called the purifier. He's being remembered as a child. So why? Because Krishna is in a body form. He'll be taking rebirth again and again because he's in the cycle of birth. So how can he transform when he himself is getting degraded? And you also say Shyam Sundar, which means, Shyam means of course evening, that is impurity. Significance of Shyam is impurity actually, and Sundar is beautiful, which is morning, and that is purity. And that's why we have the remembrance of Krishna as Shyam Sundar. Shri Baba said that if someone is a devotee of Krishna, so they'll be saying that Krishna is present everywhere. I can see Krishna everywhere. And those who believe in the Supreme Soul, that is Paramatma, they say that every soul is just a, you can say, detached form of Supreme Soul. That is, it's basically a part of Supreme Soul. And Supreme Soul is responsible to perform all sort of actions. He is here who's conducting all sort of actions. Soul is not responsible for anything. This is what they believe. Shri Baba says this is wrong. Second point that Baba has talked about devotion is that all of those sages and holy men, they are considered as the authority of scriptures. They can't be called as the authority of devotion as well. They read scriptures and they surely have the authority. That means they can, if you put any question regarding the scripture, they can tell you what is being written in the scripture. But we cannot say that all the teachings have been imbibed in their life or not. That is another thing. And Shri Baba calls himself to be the ocean of knowledge and the authority of knowledge, because all the real knowledge is actually being completely implemented. And implementation word is itself a sort of, you can say, abusing when it comes to consider Shri Baba as the ocean of knowledge. Because of course, he is full of knowledge. There is no point of implementation, etc. Third point is that Baba has discussed about the path of devotion, that each founder of a religion comes to establish his own religion. And it is not a question of how great any of them are. It isn't anyone's greatness. It is only when the father enters Brahma that there can be his greatness. And he was simply carrying on with his business. Baba said that all the founders of different religions, there is no greatness of them. Why? Because Shiv Baba is there at behind. Shiv Baba says, I am the intellect of all the intelligence individuals, because Shiv Baba is inspiring to do great karma. So there is no point of giving or getting influenced of any individual for their or his or her greatness. Like Shiv Baba said that Brahma, you can have the greatness towards Brahma because Shiv Baba has practically entered inside him. Shiv Baba also talked about another important thing of the path of devotion, and that is, they say that Shiv bought the Gangas, that the Gangas emerged through Bhagirath, that is the lucky chariot. How could water emerge from someone's head? Is Bhagirath sitting in the mountains that the Gangas could emerge through his hair? The rain that falls is drawn from the oceans, Baba is telling. This is a practical thing that we need to understand. Bhagirath is not sitting in the mountains that the Gangas could emerge through his hair. The rain that falls is drawn from the oceans, and then the water falls all over the world. There are rivers everywhere, and the water on the mountains becomes ice, and that ice continues to melt and then flows into river. The water from the caves in the mountains also fill the wells. So they too depend on rain. Shiv Baba is specifying that there is no point of having the false belief that Bhagirath is sitting somewhere and he's emerging the Ganga from his head. This is just a significance or a remembrance of how Shiv Baba enters inside the lucky chariot, that is Brahma Baba, and conveys his knowledge through his mouth, you can say lotus mouth. And like Shiv Baba, if we talk about the Srimad, so Shiv Baba said that there are many of you who do not consider themselves to be students because they don't study at all. And Baba is here to teach knowledge and yoga, so it's important to have connection with the Father. Baba said Bharat is absolutely a brothel today, where it was previously the temple of Shiv, and Shiv Baba is here to make it again. Shiv Baba also said that you are here to learn the pilgrimage of remembrance, so it's important to keep a firm eye on the remembrance thing. And another one more important aspect of devotion that Baba has discussed, that there is an example of the king who conquered attachment, and all of those examples are false because nobody can be a conqueror of attachment without having Baba here. And Shiv Baba said that you children must not get confused about any aspect regarding Baba if you have any sort of bad company, so you should not get influenced by that. Don't sulk and stop studying, or don't have this foolishness of going apart from that and opening a center. Because if you're opening a center by having this understanding of a revengeful attitude, so the success of the service is surely going to decline. Om Shanti.